Hello everyone, welcome to my channel again. Today I'm going to show you one of the important building blocks of AutoGen, that is the code executors. So basically, in this video, I'm going to show you how to run the code executors. It's very intuitive and very easy, and you can also check this documentation here in the AutoGen website. It describes the overview and local execution and also the example code. So we are going to run this example code and see if it works. The reason I'm making this video is that yesterday I tried a project to actually make multiple agents to talk with each other and to generate code. But eventually, if the agents can provide like a numerical output. For example, I ask it to generate the 14th Fibonacci number. It can generate an output. I can see in the chat history. But when I ask it to generate a graph, for example, now I want to understand if the stock price is going up or going down. I want to see the trend. This graph, I cannot find it in the local environment. So I guess there must be some problem in the code generation process. So now I go to the more basic building block of this agent's interaction using AutoGen. So now I'm checking the code executor. This will be a more simple module that we can try. So basically, my first suggestion is that you could check this website to read the document carefully. I'm not going to go through everything. I'm just going to directly to the code. Let's see if it works. So basically, if you create a Python notebook, you can start running this code. Okay, so basically in this example, it does not intrigue the local LLM. So we do not even need the LLM Studio. You can see also in the example code that the LLM configuration for the code executed agents is false. Okay, so it will not interact with the LLM. I'm going to enlarge this window to let you better visualize the code. So basically, the first step is to import the relevant modules, and it will start to create a local command line code executor. This is the executor. This is kind of a very interesting structure because when I built the agents to talk with each other and generate code, the structure is the same. Basically, in AutoGen, I don't know if it is mandatory, but now I only see this solution. So first of all, you need this executor to actually work on the code. Okay, because it is a local command line code executor, and you also need a code executor agent. This agent is a conversable agent, which means that it can generate conversations, and it will quote this executor that we created here. So basically, I think this is a most important part which you if you are going to try let the multiple agents interact with each other and generate code and run it locally, this part will not change much. Okay, so in the later videos I'm going to show you, because now I still have many bugs I need to fix. So at this moment, let's focus on this one. Let's see how the executors work. Okay, apart from the LLM configuration, code execution configuration. Here is a human input mode always. So it will ask you to input anything. But if you don't input this prompt, I think the information to the agent, you can always cancel and it will keep on running the code. About the executor, I don't think there's much to mention. It has a timeout for the code execution in seconds. After 10 seconds, it will time out. And it also link to this temporary directory. At this moment, I have not yet set it arbitrarily to a folder I want. But at this moment, I'm going to Leave it like this, okay? So this temporary directory you can print later to check. The next step is to install all the packages that's needed, okay? Like it is 100% the same as the AutoGen documentation. So basically, from my point of view, I think here it actually build this string or this paragraph. It's called a message with code block. So actually, the code is existing. We already provide it and to put it in a variable, and we let the agent to act on it. So the possible variation, I think, in the future, for example, this one, the code block could be generated during the conversation with multiple agents interaction, and of course. You can also manually input a code or even quote from GitHub and so on, because I already see some example which can do such things. But here, for simplicity, I think AutoGen documentation displays this part as a fixed coding part. You can see this code is a complete Python code, and the next part is to generate a reply from a given code. So actually, is the code execute agent, the conversable agent, to start to generate a reply, okay, based on this message. Okay, so it is defining it. It is like the LM Studio Assistant message structure, is to tell the system the role of the conversable agent. The role here is a user that utilizing a content, okay, and to input to the system as a prompt, and eventually it will print the reply. Okay, when I run this part, I can show you. Okay, when you click around, because the previous part I already run, I'm going to show you only this part. So you see here the prompt input box. You can input anything you want. If you don't want, you just exit. Okay, and no human input received. And it finished. It just finished the code. And this one execute zero is execution succeeded. Then you go to the code output scatter plot. Okay, where is it saved? I checked, it is in this temporary file, this folder. So I go to my folder, and this is the picture I saw. So basically, running this part of the code is intuitive, easy, and you can quickly try if it is successful. So there are still several things we can improve. First of all, is to set the temporary directory to the directory we want, so we can have better control to see the result. And of course, the naming of the output file, of course, you can make more detail, provide more detail, so you can search later and utilize later. And the further improvement is to use this small building block to the agent's interaction. Because when you ask different agents to talk with each other in the future video I'm going to show you are going to meet many problems. It's not like they talk with each other, the code will run successfully. Largely, when you try it, I think you will meet many problems. So today we view the first building block, and in the future we are going to explore how, first of all, how we can ask the agent to write the code for us. Then ask the agents to interact with each other to check the code, test the code, see if the code is doing well. Okay. And there are also many, many more potentials that we can explore. I wish this video is clear to you. And thank you for the support. If you have any doubt, any question, feel free to leave a comment. Have a nice day. Bye bye.